I don't have much hair up there. Colonize.
You know, if the rabbit, if you're super anxious and the rabbit bites the tip of your finger off, then you're not anxious anymore. That's how therapy animals work.
Save it.
Nope. Just give it to, you'll eat it.
Don't eat it though, just save it. Hi, I'm Burke Collins.
I'm Damian Brady.
And this is 5 Things About Azure
DevOps.
That's right.
We're here at Microsoft Build 2018, and it doesn't look like we are. Looks like we're at a petting zoo, but we are actually at the conference, and we've got these. Oh, easy. What's it? What's this one's name? Settle down.
Alfie.
Alfie. We've got rabbits and little Sebastian, ponies. That dog's passed out over there. Anyway, we're in the therapy area over here, which is awesome. And this is provided by Animals as Natural Therapy, a great organization that works with veterans and other underprivileged kids in foster care who had struggled with a lot of anxiety, like myself. Working with these animals helps a lot with that. So I personally am glad these horses are here because I can see how awkward it is making you feel. Also, I've heard that rabbits will bite you, so.
I've heard that too. No, I've still have a laptop.
Thing number one. What is Azure
DevOps?
Damian.
Is that an Australian accent?
Yes.
It's really, really bad.
Would you like a bumper sticker for your Subaru Outback? Crocodile Dundee. Gonna quit the band again, Brit. Okay.
That's New Zealand.
Same thing. Thing number one. What is Azure
DevOps? Azure DevOps
is the new product name for Visual Studio Team Services, which is Microsoft's DevOps product.
I was about to say, that doesn't help me much. Yeah.
It's Microsoft's DevOps product, end-to-end DevOps lifecycle from source control and work item planning all the way through to your builds and releases and monitoring what's happening in production and everything about your application cycle.
So for those who don't know what DevOps is, would it be accurate to say that it's a tool for pulling in code, building, test, running all your tests, deploying? Do I have all that right, or do I misunderstand how DevOps works?
Well, DevOps itself is not really a tool. So Microsoft's definition of DevOps is the union of people,
process, and products to enable continuous delivery of value to our end users.
You lost me at like the union of people. Everything after that, I wasn't even listening.
People, process, products.
Okay, that I can do.
Yep, and delivering continuous value.
Now, so you just added something else at the end.
There's more words. So it's about delivering value to the people using your software by ultimately making that process better of getting the right things into production and making sure they're the right things when they're in production.
Can't you just right-click deploy?
No, you cannot do that.
Why not?
Because that's
how I do it.
Yeah, I know.
I deploy all my software that way. I've been doing it wrong, apparently.
That's wrong.
Nicole Kidman.
No.
Hugh Jackman. That's your therapy horse back
there. That's my therapy.
He's 5,000 candles. Cool. Thing number two, what is it that
Azure DevOps
actually does?
Well, it is the product that streamlines all of the stuff you need to do for DevOps. It holds your source control, it tracks your items, like your work items, the things you're going to do. It does your builds, it does your releases, and it helps you monitor what's going on in production with your application.
What if my code is somewhere else, though? Like it's in GitHub, or I've got a different source control provider?
Yeah, you can plug in GitHub. You can grab your source code from pretty much anywhere.
So it'll pull in your code from pretty much any repository.
Yep. It can even talk to other deployment processes and other tools that you might already use. So you don't have to use all of it, but it's all there for you.
What about Visual Source Safe?
You can maybe use that if you want.
Visual Source Safe, hashtag never forget. That horse is running your
back. Does this mean I'm misbehaving?
He knows that you're anxious, Damien. He's trying to settle you down. Okay. Good job. Thing number three, I don't get paid a lot to do this show, so how much is this going to cost me?
So it's free.
Free?
It is free.
But what's the catch?
Well, it's up to 5 users. It's free. But if you have a Visual Studio Enterprise subscription, which a lot of companies do, then that doesn't count towards that. And you have a limited number of build minutes with the hosted builds.
So is it included in the Enterprise subscription?
It's included in the Enterprise subscription.
So anybody that already has the Enterprise subscription already has access to this tool?
They do.
Nice. But not me. I don't have an Enterprise.
You work for Microsoft. You have everything.
No, they don't give me anything, except for these 3 ponies and that rabbit that almost bit my finger. Thing number four.
Azure DevOps.
Formerly known as Visual Studio Team Services, has Visual Studio in it, which makes me think that you're trying to get me to use Windows. Like, you're sneaking it in there. Is that what's happening with this tool? Well, for JavaScript and Node developers, a lot of us use Macs and Linux and environments that are not on Windows. So how does that work?
So it's any language, any platform. So you can write .NET and compile and build and release .NET, but you can also do Node. You can also do pretty much any language. Go, Ruby, Python,
COBOL.
JavaScript, COBOL, yeah.
You could
totally do
it. I build web apps in COBOL.
Do you?
Is that even possible? I don't know. I have no idea.
You can do it.
Well, I'm going to do it right after this.
Yeah.
Thing number five, you can get started with Azure
DevOps
today by going to, where are we going?
dev.azure.com.
dev.azure.com. Get started today for free. I'm Burke Collins.
I'm Damian Brady.
And now you know five things about
Azure DevOps.
It's a bad accent.
I'm done.
It's great.